version of the beginning of the end. We're jamming freestyle in New England, and now we're jamming all around the world. And CPR with you. Seven FM WTCC. We are here live with GA George Anthony.
Yep, yep.
And we're previewing it. Nothing Like Your Love, the album. That was track number 13, a duet with the Princess of Style, Miss Cynthia Figueroa, 2015 version of the beginning of the end. And we were just talking about how that song is going to be 20 years old next year. Amazing, but also kind of hard to believe, right?
Yeah,
20 years. It is timeless. Now, you have how many producers that assisted you in this particular journey?
Four.
And who are they?
Your boy, Jay Allums. My boy, Jay Allums. I got Willie Valentin on there as well. Carlos Belmont, who did the acoustic versions of I Love You. And and Line in the Sand, written by Jonell. And I co-produced a lot of it, too. You know, I did a lot of co-production on it. So yeah.
Talk about the actual road trips and the trips that you took. Like, you drove a lot of different areas. You went to Chicago.
Yes.
Via plane, and you drove around, but you also went to New Jersey, right?
Yeah, Jersey. I mean, that's where my studio is in Jersey City, in my house in Jersey City. And, you know, since Jay moved out to Chicago, we actually did a little mini setup out there. So, you know, I would take advantage when I had a show or something and just go to Jay Adams's, you know, studio and do some stuff there. And also worked out of Willie Valentin's and Carlos Belmont, which is also in Jersey. So I did a lot of traveling to get this album done, but I think it was worth it.
Now, has your mentor, Biggie Garcia from Mi'kmaq Records, heard your album?
I'm not sure, but, you know, I saw him on his birthday. I went to his house, and he knows I'm doing a lot of stuff. And, you know, he's just very supportive, as always. Mickey's a great guy. I mean, we have so much history. I mean, he was there from the very beginning. I was on Mi'kmaq, and, yeah, he's always had that faith. He's always had that support for me. And if he heard it, I'm sure, you know, he'll reach out and let me know what he thinks about it. But yeah, I mean, I'm not sure if he has, but I'm sure that'll be all positive.
Now, time for you to go. You you released it in 2014, and it made it up the top 10. I believe it was number 4 for 2014. But now, for 2015, you brought it back, and you added Wendy and Molly Mays again.
Yeah.
How did Wendy and Molly Mays get into the picture on this remix?
It's just so funny because, you know, that Time for You to Go, I wrote it in 1993. I just never released it.
Wow.
Charlie Baby produced it, and it got lost. I had it on a cassette, and it just got lost. So I even had to write the second verse over because I couldn't remember for the life of me what the second verse was, but I always knew what the first verse was. And I said, Jay showed me an instrumental, and I said, I love the instrumental. We just got to change some stuff. So I sang it to him, and then we started, of course, producing the new Time for You to Go. And then we changed the chorus on it. You know, it was a different chorus, which is still hot. I think I'm actually going to record the original chorus on a different version for the George Anthony 2.0 album. I'm just kidding.
Already?
We'll see. I'm not sure yet. But yeah, you know, it was, yeah, we got very into it for this Time for You to Go song. And then I loved the way it came out, and I got a lot of good feedback on it. And then as the months went by, I said, you know what, we should just do a duet. When I called Wendy, she was down, and she says, you know, I can relate to this song, so I want to be down. And then I decided to call it the Team Reese remix, because, you know, she says that she can relate to it too. So it was perfect. I think it was a great thing to do.
If you hear furniture moving in the background, or you hear pictures being taken, is our photographer Willie Valentin, who's
slash
just,
videographer.
He's just sliding and going through nooks and crannies of the radio station and the studio. Uh-oh.
Oh,
wow. Just get the selfie stick.
You got the American Sniper pose.
Yeah. Unbelievable. So right now we're going to get into the number one song here on CPR's Top 10 Countdown for 2 weeks in a row.
Shout out to Pose.
It's the Team Reese remix of George Anthony featuring Wendy and Molly Mays. It's time for you to go. 2015, and CPR with you, along with Willie Valentin and G.A. George Anthony.
I climb the highest mountain to find out where you are. I'm searching for a love that's true. But every time I see you, you want to turn away and tell me that we are through. I got to move on. I got to be strong. Forget the memories. Just let it all out, because there's no doubt that it's time for you to know. Something's breathing, something's breathing in your heart. Stay through my heart.
CPR with you on a Friday night. We are joined by GA, George Anthony. Anything you want to say about the album that I haven't covered? Any thank yous, shout outs?
No, just shout outs to everybody. Just because if I start mentioning names, they'll hit me up and be like, hey, you forgot to mention me. But I just want to thank all my friends, all the fans of the music that have been so supportive. And I've gotten so much feedback and comments and, you know, all these motivating and inspiring, you know, like, you know, feedback and comments, and I love it. It just, you know, keeps me motivated. So, you know, I'm just very thankful. If you haven't gotten the CD yet, it's called Nothing Like Your Love. Available anywhere that music is sold, and you can go to artisticrecordings.com to purchase it. And I mean, we've exceeded expectations. Everything right now is just a bonus, and I'm just glad that everybody likes it. And like you mentioned, Jose, you know, we have the legends, you know, calling me and saying, yo, it's a nice album, it's a good album, good stuff. You know, and I have, you know, people that are dedicated freestyle listeners from when, you know, that only listen to George Lamont and Stevie B and TK saying, hey, you're like a hidden gem, you know, and stuff like that, which is all great and kind and motivating words. And I'm just going to keep doing it. The more I get that type of feedback, the more it makes me want to do this type of music.
What keeps you doing it is the question.
That, man, to be honest with you, I graduated college a couple of years ago, and that's how this album came about. Like, I needed a hobby because I was just so used to going to work and then going to school at night. So at night I was like, oh man, I graduated.
Right.
You know, I got my bachelor's degree, and what do I do now? So I said, I'm going to start singing. Let me see if I can dust off the cobwebs. And I went to my boy, Carlos Belmont, and we started singing. I said, yeah, I think I can still do it. And then I called Willie. I said, and then of course you introduced me to Jay Allums. And then one thing just led to another, and that's, you know, the fact that I could still do it. That's one of the reasons why I still do it. And a lot of people just ask me, you know, you should do it. If you can still do it, do it.
Here's the best part, and this is the reason why I call it the Perfect 10. And the Perfect 10 means that it's just the perfect album, and I've explained it already.
Thank you so much.
But there's not one bad song on here.
I mean, I'm going to agree with you because I, I,